Banks, what's that in your hand?
Don't worry, Jasmine. The world would be a better place without you.
Banks, you've not given me a chance to defend myself.
I am sure you're wondering what is happening. Let's go back a few months. Meet Bankole, or Banks for short. The only thing we know about him is that he's a transfer student from another university. Why he transferred, we don't know yet. Meet Jasmine, Jazz for short. Yeah, you've got to admit she's cute. And trust me when I say she's not your regular Ninja babe.
Sorry for bothering you, I'm kind of new around here. I usually come with men in the barber shop. Yeah, you're a girl. I was hoping you know where your boyfriend gets his haircut.
Oh, I see. And there's a good one by the streets. So I hear.
Noted, thanks.
Thanks. You know there are easier ways of acting than how to do
that. I see.
I don't. You heard me.
Oh, I'm so sorry. Have a seat. What are you doing?
The next time they met, Jasmine gave a seemingly shy Bankole her phone number. Yeah, she's that type of girl.
Yeah, my number. Now you have my number.
After a while of familiarization, Jazz and Bankole got acquainted with each other. Bankole was always at the right place and at the right time. Guy was so smooth, which really made Jasmine fall for him.
Hey Jasmine.
Hi. How are you doing? Good. I feel like I've been exercised. Nice.
Yeah, it's good to work out once in a while.
I swear you get the physique from. What's the barbershop?
It was nice.
Oh, okay. Alright.
Anyway, I don't want to disturb you much.
Yeah.
I'm just going there.
Alright, let me let you be too, so.
Alright.
Nice exercising. Ciao, ciao.
Alright.
Remember when I said that she wasn't a regular Ninja babe? Just unlike most ladies, know what she wants and go straight for it. And in this case, it was Bankole she wanted. After After a couple of visits at Jasmine's apartment, she was already in love. But you got to admit, looking at Bankole, who wouldn't have? This is where I need you to pay a very close attention. Things are about to get ugly really, really fast.
Finally awake.
What's going on, Banks?
Oh, you still don't know what's happening?
What? What are we doing here?
You're so dumb.
Oh my gosh, my appointment!
Your appointment? It should be the least of your troubles right now.
Banks, please, what's going on?
Exactly a year ago, my brother was diagnosed of brain damage.
Who is your brother? Banks, please tell me, what are you talking about?
To really understand what Bankole is aiming at, we have to go to the actual beginning. You are familiar with Jasmine? This is Elton, Bankole's elder brother. Elton was the typical lover boy, the kind of guy that loves a lady with his whole heart.
Lover boy?
You've started again.
Started what now?
Frida, just stop. Just stop. Just stop it.
Joe boy. Sorry. Take a beg.
But you're supposed to be happy for me, you know.
Chill, okay? I'm simply looking out for you.
Looking out for me? Why? Am I in danger?
You're getting me wrong, Elden.
So what exactly are you saying?
Look. Girls are the most confusing creatures on earth. Yes, I said it, and I mean it.
And?
That aside, she's just a 100-level student. 100-level students are the most unstable people on earth. They just got into school. They don't even know what they want, and they've not figured out life yet.
How does that even affect my relationship with Jazz?
I'm just saying, okay? There's every tendency that she could dump you anytime. You have to make peace with that. Dude, the world is fucked up.
I should break up with her then?
No.
Then what should I do, Frida?
Oh, just make sure you use your head, okay? Don't get all loved up and end up getting heartbroken.
Look, Frida, chill. No one's breaking my heart. I understand that you're concerned, but me and Jazzy's relationship is going great. Our connection is just, our vibe is on a whole different level right now. Trust me, no one is breaking each other's hearts.
Vibes are inshallah.
Yeah, you know they say.
She look like a guarantee, but she go chop for me if I give her cocoa.
Okay, please bring your laptop. Let me show those pictures.
Oh, yeah. You know I create banging pictures.
Oshé,
right?
Bangali.
Elton was also a photographer, and on this occasion he lodged in an hotel with his friend and work buddy Aisha. They were in another state on a photography job together.
Yo, Jazz, what's up? How are you? Why are you sounding like that? I miss you more.
I really wish you were here with me.
So, tell me something, Jazz. What would you do if
I was standing right in front of you?
Like now?
Baby! Hi, Jasmine.
Hi, Aisha.
Elton is already asleep.
Wake him up, he was expecting my call.
He had a very long day today, and tomorrow is going to be equally stressful, so he really needs to sleep.
Okay,
Jasmine,
but
you guys can talk tomorrow. Good night, Jasmine.
Elton, are you there?
Yo, morning, Jazz.
So you are too busy to talk to me.
What are you talking about?
Are you really playing the innocent game?
What game? Look, Jazz, you have to help me. I'm totally lost.
Elton! Are you really doing this? Elton, go take a shower. Wow.
Look, Jazz, I have to go. I'll call you some other time.
Are you kidding me?
I love you. I love you. I'm coming. Just give me a minute.
At this moment, Jasmine was really upset. And when she gets upset, wow.
Good morning, Usas.
She had this friend, or what people today call bestie, Osas. Jasmine was about to make a really bad decision.
Shh.
Fast forward to where Elton and Aisha, we're back from the trip.
You, Jazz, what's up? Jazz.
Don't jazz me.
Are you still upset with me?
No, I'm not upset. I'm totally fine with my boyfriend lodging with another lady. For a whole week.
Come on, Jazz.
No, I'm not upset. Especially when everyone knows Aisha has a crush on you.
You know Aisha and I are simply work buddies.
Work buddies? More like fuck buddies.
Are you being serious now? We went for a fucking job. You don't expect me to live in the midst of a job because my girlfriend is feeling insecure.
Wow, so are you really doing this? So I'm insecure now.
You know, I try to be a good boyfriend. Not just a good boyfriend, a fucking great one at that. I do literally everything you ask. I make sure you feel loved, Jazz. But I go for a job that will obviously benefit my life. Just because I went with a female colleague. All of a sudden, I'm a cheat. Oh, and let's not forget, Aisha was the one who actually got the job. She only tagged me along because we were friends, but no. My girlfriend has issues with that.
I cheated, Elton.
You did what?
Yes, I did. And it's your fault.
Are you fucking kidding me?
If only you did not love your work more than me, I wouldn't have had to.
Are you mad? Are you actually mad? Did you drink before you got here?
It's obvious you always put photography before me.
You know, you're a freaking psycho.
I guess we both know what needs to be done now.
How the fuck do you cheat on me and still have the audacity to talk to me like that? Leave my place, Jazz. I just can't stand you right now.
If I leave, I'm never coming back to you or to this relationship. It's either we fix this now or there's nothing to fix afterwards.
Fix what now?
The choice is yours.
Get out of my house.
I guess it's settled then. I wish you luck in photography, since that's the only
when
thing
you're dating
love.
A lover boy like Elton.
Fuck you!
This was the kind of stuff you couldn't come back from. Some might actually say it was his fault, but I guess he could have handled the situation a little bit differently. This is Samantha, a model. She is here to select pictures for a shoot she had with Elton before he traveled for the event.
Yeah, so you can just pick the ones you like.
Oh, I think I like this one.
I think I do. You like it, right?
Yeah, I do.
Yeah, you just keep scrolling. Keep scrolling.
Much can't be said about Samantha.
except for the fact that she was a small scale drug dealer.
Chill, you just saw me take it away. It's totally safe. Just one of these will have you clap. Come on, you deserve it.
Wanting to forget about Jasmine made a life-changing decision.
Brother!
So your brain has finally woken up from sleep mode.
Elton is your brother.
Yes, he's my brother. And thanks to you, he's in a fucking coma for about a year now.
Oh, I had nothing to do with that.
Oh, you had everything to do with it. If you hadn't broken up with him, if you hadn't been so fucking needy, self-centered, egocentric, if he hadn't been so dire in need of attention, he wouldn't be in the hospital bed right now.
Banks, please stop talking like that.
You cheated on him and still broke up with him. Like, how could you do that when you knew how emotionally he was vested in you?
Banks, I think you're being irrational right now.
I'm being irrational. I'm fucking being irrational. After everything I said, that's the only thing you could say. Elton only went for that gig to better his career. But you just had to use that as an excuse for your shitty nature. Do you know how draining it has been? All these months, putting up with you, working with you, talking with you.
I enjoyed that a little bit.
You deserve what you get tonight. We'll see the grand finale in a few moments.
Banks, you've not given me a chance to defend myself.
There's no need for that. Your actions already have.
What's that in your hand?
Don't worry, Jasmine. The world would be a better place without you. The doctor said Elton was overdosed. It's only right that you go out the same way.
Bunt, I'm sorry. I'm so sorry.
This is your redemption.
so many unanswered questions. But the main question is, who told Bankole what had happened? Build Aisha, our mastermind. She basically sets the whole thing up. Bankole was only a prophet in the story.
It's not bad.
If I pick on her, Duke, sharp, shall I just run it? Run before she.
The
shot is dedicated to everybody behind the camera.
Only you behold my body.
Baby, everybody's the same. No one loves you like this. No one loves you like I do. Love to the morning. I want all the love from your loving. I just need you beside me. Hey.